here today with Randy Levasseur, who is running for Royal Oak City Commission for a partial term. How are you doing today?
I'm doing well, Crystal.
Can you talk a little bit about, one, why is this a partial term? Just to explain it to voters, and why are you running for it?
Well, our current mayor, Mr. Fournier, this was his seat, and he had to vacate it to become mayor this past December. Under our charter, he was replaced temporarily by the sitting commissioners. They chose someone to fill his role. But that was only to fill his seat until the next regular city election, which is this November. So this seat is to fill the remaining 2 years on Mr. Fournier's seat that he was elected to 2 years ago.
And why did you decide to run for it?
Well, I've lived in Royal Oak since 1988. It's a great city. But we do have some problems in our city government. The priorities of our city government don't seem to be reflected well. They don't seem to be in sync with the priorities of our residents here in the town. So, for example, residents, they're concerned with making sure that we have good roads, we have public safety, trash is picked up, the sewers work, the parks are maintained. And they're willing to pay for those services, but they do want the city government to work hard to keep the cost down. And our current elected officials seem to have very different priorities. Rather than focusing on the quality of life in our neighborhoods, they're very focused on what's happening in our downtown. They're more inclined, a greater priority to bring in and build tall buildings in our downtown. That's more important to them than making sure our downtown remains a inviting place for residents who may just want to make a quick stop at the library or the post office, the farmer's market, or grab a cup of coffee. The city officials also have not done a good job of keeping costs down. We've seen our millage rate go up by 50% in the last 5 years. We've seen residents forced to pay for either sidewalk installations where they weren't needed or wanted, sometimes over $10,000 per household, or homeowners forced to pay to repair sidewalks. It really had only the most minor defects, nothing that was a safety issue. But you know, again, residents, they're more than happy to pay for quality services. They do want the city to keep costs down, and they're willing to do that for public safety, willing to do that for roads. But as soon as the voters gave the city the funds for those very critical needs, we see the public officials vote to give a $5.5 million taxpayer subsidy to a private developer who's very politically connected. They voted to give that developer one of the most valuable pieces of real property in our downtown, a very convenient parking lot behind Mr. B's. And that kind of triggers other expenses that involve $56 million in public facilities. And when you add it all up, it's more than $2,000 per household. Those are not the priorities of the residents who live in this town. That's not how they would choose to spend those funds. I do believe we need representatives in the commission who are going to listen to the residents and more accurately reflect the priorities of the residents of Royal Oak.
Now, that civic center development has been an issue in this election. How would you handle it differently?
Well, first thing, you need to maintain the buildings that you have. The city hall has been neglected, and it's something that certainly if you're putting aside money year to year to maintain, you don't get into a problem where it's being deemed to be unfixable, which isn't true. It's what our city manager likes to say. He calls it functionally obsolete. That basically means you have to take two steps to get to one place instead of one. But the other aspect of it's such a major change for our community. It dramatically changes the footprint of our downtown. It's extremely expensive. Nothing like that should be happening with input from the voters of this town. In fact, our charter would basically require it because of the debt involved, the money that needs to be involved. Our charter would require it to be voted upon by the citizens, and our commission doesn't see it that way, and they're doing everything they can to avoid giving voters that choice.
Now, from a professional standpoint, can you talk a little bit about your work experience and what skills you bring to this position?
Yeah, sure. I graduated from University of Michigan Law School in 1988 and moved here to start my career, and I've been here ever since. I decided to focus on real estate law shortly after I became an attorney. I started my own real estate law firm in 1999 and have been self-employed all these years since then. In 2010, I also started a small business that's dedicated to helping homeowners reduce their property taxes. And very proud that over the years we've been able to help the owners of thousands of homes across Michigan reduce their property taxes and save them millions of dollars in the process.
Now, how have you been involved in the Ray Luke community?
Oh, quite a few things over the years. It dates back to when my son, who he's 20 now, but when he was little, I would help out assistant coaching with his baseball team or his soccer team, helping out with Cub Scout events. He went through the Shrine Schools, and so I did a lot of stuff volunteering there, whether it's being a tour guide for parents and prospective students at open houses, or helping with Christmas tree sales to raise funds, helping with concession sales or security at sporting events, end of the year cleanup of the grounds around the school, or helping with distracted driver programs for the high school students at the high school. And in addition to that, there's been other things. For example, the Royal Oak Memorial Society, they have a very nice program every year where they help clean the graves of veterans who have their final resting place over at the Oakview Cemetery. And it's a situation where those graves are very close to the ground and they make it covered with turf. And you know, we have volunteers that go there and help clean those graves so that they can be seen and those soldiers can be honored during Memorial Day festivities. And in addition, I've helped out with programs to honor seniors who have served our country in the military, to show them the thanks for their service to our country.
Now, there are two people running for this position. Why should people vote for you?
Well, my opponent, I don't know him well. He seems to be a very nice young man. He has a lot of energy, and I appreciate that about him. I do believe, just because I'm roughly 20 years older than him, I simply have more life experiences than he's had time to have yet. You know, experiences, you know, being a homeowner, a taxpayer, a parent, an attorney, a businessman. And these are experiences that I can draw upon when I'm serving the residents in the city commission to make decisions that will help our community. We also have very different perspectives on this city center development. You know, he's come out in favor of giving that $5.5 million subsidy to the private developer, giving that private parking lot to the developer, and spending that over $2,000 per household on the new government facilities downtown. That's a very distinct difference between him and me. And certainly voters, you know, they need to decide what experiences that they believe make for a good commissioner and what priorities the candidates have that better reflect their priorities.
So if people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
Well, they can call me at area code 248-733-5840. They can also visit me on the web at chooserandy.com. They can find me on Facebook by typing Choose Randy into the search box. Or they could email me at randy@chooserandy.com.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you, Crystal.